So tell me what you're finding today.
Oh, it's amazing. It's crazy. I heard that in 2015 there will be more trashy than fish in the sea.
Yes, that's correct.
I think if it's like that, it will become true.
Yes.
Okay, and what are you finding here?
Yeah.
A lot of small foam.
Styrofoam.
Yeah.
So that's the plastic packaging and
yes.
things, cigarette butts
yes.
as well.
Yeah.
Okay. And so your name is?
Hudson.
And where are you from?
Brazil.
Brazil. Tudo bem?
Yeah. Tudo bem.
Good, good. And yourself, ma'am?
Romania.
Romania. And can your first name?
Alina.
Alina, pleased to meet you. Good.
Two, one. So in this beautiful beach in South Africa, I'm finding polystyrene. Plastic code number 6. 95% air. Based on toxic raw materials, so benzene and styrene, both are carcinogenic. And because it's 95% air, it's so light, and it gets into little crevices and really, really difficult to clean up. Ultimately, one of the plastics that should be banned because of its problematic nature in the waste stream. 95% air means you can't transport it. And when you can't transport it, recycling is pretty much you lose income on recycling polystyrene. So only a few countries like Luxembourg and Germany actually compress this material and then are able to create new products. And this is actually EPS, so expanded polystyrene. So they're expanding with air. The normal polystyrene is cutlery, which I haven't found. And another bad boy in plastic is multi-layer foil packaging. So you see this is aluminum on the inside and printed plastic on the outside. And the problem with this is it's two different polymer types and a spray-on aluminium. So the spray-on coating is too thin to recycle effectively, or at least get income from it. And having two polymers on the inside and the outside of different nature means their melting points are different, and so you can't recycle them. So these are really two common plastic items that are terrible.
Okay, so one of the things I know is that most chip packets are made by Pepsi Cola.
Yeah.
And then styrene is produced by one family. The styrene, they own polystyrene,
really?
And they produce, they own the royalties to all of it.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Yeah, and ultimately these companies that produce these products should be responsible for them. Because we as consumers are buying the product. We want Lay's chips. We want our crispy chips. And this is a fantastic packaging to give you crispy chips because it blocks UV radiation. So your chips don't change color. And there's a fantastic gas barrier because of these two plastics and metal. So we want the chips, but ultimately we don't want the waste, and we don't want to be responsible for the company for this product once we throw it away. The company that's selling it to us and making the profit has to be responsible. So I think ultimately our governments need to wake up and make these companies responsible for their packaging quickly change to other materials.
Yeah. Go.
Hi, I'm Lisa. I found some glass. I also find a lot of styrofoam, I think they use to pack the food. And there's also some cigarettes, some plastic for sweet, and a bottle of whatever, apple juice.
Apple juice.
Hi, my name is Mariela. I'm with Polish team here, and we're lifting the seaweed things. And finding really awful loads of styrofoam. The thing is that sometimes it's white, but sometimes it's also black. So you cannot recognize really until you touch it, whether it's a seaweed or it's a styrofoam. Sometimes the pieces are big like this, sometimes they are super small. So sometimes you really need to dig a bit more deeper in the sand to find something. It's sad.
One and go.
Hi, my name is Teresa. I'm part of this group, of the StartUpcycling group, because I'm really convinced that everyone can make a difference, and we need to start small with collecting waste just around us. We need to raise awareness, we need to affect all the people around us to stop wasting our planet. And it's quite inspiring to see people from all over the world of this project now collecting waste along the ocean and along the wetlands. So I'm quite happy to be part of it. And I look forward to upcycle what we can out of this waste that we are collecting.